Hello everybody and welcome to the Higher Music Technology Past Paper Questions video guide for this year. Before we get started on taking a look at the paper and trying some of these questions, can you please make sure that you have headphones and you have them plugged into your device because you will need them for the paper. You will have headphones provided to you in both the fab and in the exam as well. We're going to start off with question one. Question one is nice and easy. It starts off generally just taking a look at styles and some kind of features within those styles as well. So part A you can see is a multi-choice question. Now usually with these you're asked to identify two terms from the list below, and in the list you will have around three different styles of music and two different other concepts or musical features that would be present. Part B, in this question, you're also asked to identify some musical features present that are typical of the genre style. So for revising for these kind of questions, I would recommend using your genres sheet. Let's give this one a go and see how we do.
Question 1. A. Listen to this excerpt and identify two terms from the list below which describe what you hear. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me.
Here is the music for the second time.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me.
B. Listen to the excerpt again. Describe two music features present which are typical of the genre style.
Cupid, draw back your bow and let your arrow flow straight to my lover's heart for me. No, nobody else but me. Cupid, please hear my cry.
Okay, so the answers to these questions were for question 1A, our style was reggae and our little musical feature in there was a counter melody, which you would have been able to hear in the kind of synth string part above it. And in part B, listen to the excerpt again, describe two music features present which are typical of the genre style. So the style is reggae, so the potential answers for that are beats 2 and 4 are emphasised, there's a repeated riff pattern, there's offbeat chords, simple repeated chord pattern, expressive and soulful vocals, a relaxed performance, backing vocals singing in harmony, a prominent bass part, and a syncopated bass line. So those are all of your potential options. So if you've got two of those, give yourself 2 marks on that question. Moving on to part two, again, this focuses kind of more on your genres and styles of music. In 2A, you're asked to identify the genre, a musical feature, and a technological feature or technology feature. So in this case, take a little look at your genres task sheet if you haven't done so already. And 2B, listen to the excerpt and identify one term from the list below which describes what you hear. So in this case, we've got 4 different music terms: modulation, inverted pedal, cross rhythms, and then we've got a technological term in portamento. If you don't know what any of these words mean, take a look at ataea.co.uk and you'll be able to find them under the music technology section. Let's see how we do with this question.
Question 2. A. Listen to this excerpt and identify the genre. Give 2 reasons for your answer, one referring to a music feature and the other to a technology feature. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time. Here is the music for the second time. B. Listen to this excerpt and identify one term from the list below which describes what you hear. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time.
Tablet into someone's coffee, and in a voice an awful lot of men.
Here is the music for the second time.
Okay, so the answers for these questions we'll take a quick look at just now. So number two, part A, the genre was jazz funk. Now your possible music features for jazz funk is that it includes an ostinato or riff, syncopation, extended groove sections, a melodic or complex bass line, jazz instrumentation with electric instruments, the use of a synthesizer, use of a Hammond organ or prominent bass, and you'd get one mark related to the musical concept. Possible technological features include live sound recording with minimal post-production, the use of modulation effects, the use of a synthesizer, use of a Hammond organ, use of a wah-wah, and also accepted would be use of chorus, flanger or phaser, and you would get one mark for that as well. When it comes to part B, we can do the process of elimination method for this. So the answer was cross rhythms. You could hear them in the drum kit throughout that excerpt. Moving on to question three now, we're going to do part A and B. In the question, you hear two different recordings, and for each one, you identify the fault in the recording and describe in detail how you would correct it. So in the first case, it's a vocal recording, so you can think about what is potentially going to go wrong with a vocal recording. Think back to your own assignments and what's potentially gone wrong and how you've maybe fixed it before. So you get one mark for the fault and one mark for the correction on this one. And part B, again, same thing, one mark for the fault, one mark for the correction.
Question 3. In this question, you will hear two recordings. For each one, you must identify the fault in the recording and describe in detail how to correct it. A. Listen to this excerpt of a vocal recording. Identify the recording fault and describe in detail how to correct it. You will hear this excerpt twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time.
Encouraging positive behaviour is the best way to improve attitude. People who ignore poor performance and bring a positive attitude to a situation should quickly see behaviour improve. The best bit of advice which can be given is to believe that people genuinely want to be good and that bad behaviour is taught by others, be it their colleagues, friends, peers, or even parents. The biggest issue when promoting positive behaviour is to address not just the challenging attitude, but to improve and change the behaviours of the people who surround the issue. Every positive behaviour demonstrated should be acknowledged and, if appropriate, rewarded. A plan should also be brought into play which identifies each challenge, then has a clear reaction which should be both controlled, controllable, and seek to encourage a positive response. Encouraging positive behaviour is easy to do and can make a remarkable difference.
Here is the excerpt for the second time.
Encouraging positive behaviour is the best way to improve attitude. People who ignore poor performance and bring a positive attitude to a situation should quickly see behaviour improve. The best bit of advice which can be given is to believe that people genuinely want to be good and that bad behaviour is taught by others, be it their colleagues, friends, peers, or even parents. The biggest issue when promoting positive behaviour is to address not just the challenging attitude, but to improve and change the behaviours of the people who surround the issue. Every positive behaviour demonstrated should be acknowledged and, if appropriate, rewarded. A plan should also be brought into play which identifies each challenge, then has a clear reaction which should be both controlled, controllable, and seek to encourage a positive response. Encouraging positive behaviour is easy to do and can make a remarkable difference.
You now have 1 minute to complete your answer.
As part of this video, we are going to just move straight on to part B, although in your FAB and also in your exam, you will get the 1 minute between each question to complete your answer. So in this case, for part B, we're going back in, and this time it's a fault in a MIDI track, in particular a MIDI drum track. So have a think before you even start this question about what the fault could be, and then how, if you were faced with it and creating your assignment, for example, how you would correct it as well.
B. Listen to this excerpt and identify the fault in the MIDI drum track, and describe in detail how to correct it. You will hear this excerpt twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time. Here is the excerpt for the second time. You now have 1 minute to complete your answer.
Okay, so again, in your FAB and also in your final exam, you will get the 1 minute between this question and the next question as well, but we are just going to go over the answers for the time being. So for 3A, if we think back to question 3, what we did have was, apologies, it's moved on to different slide there. There we go. So for question 3A, listen to the excerpt of a vocal recording and identify the recording fault and describe in detail how to correct it. The fault in the case of that was that there was popping and blasting present in the mix, from what you could hear from the vocals, or the mic technique or placement has been poor. So to correct that, what you could do is you could adjust the mic position, you could move the mic off axis, or you could use a pop shield, and you would get one mark for each of those that you got correct. For part B, when we're taking a look at it, so the fault for that was that the MIDI drums were out of time, and the correction was to quantize the MIDI track. So quantizing is something I would always think of straight away as soon as I see MIDI in a question. It's one thing to keep in the back of your head for that. So again, give yourself a mark for each one that you got correct. Okay, we are moving now on to question 4, which is the effects question, I like to call it. So what happens is we hear two different versions of some kind of track, and there's been some kind of effect applied to the second version of the track. Now you get three options to choose from, and then you have to justify the reason for your answer. For this question, what I like to do is I like to take a look at all three options and then straight away take a look at what's different between them. So in the case of this reverb one here, I can see that the pre-delay is set differently. The time is also set differently as well. So those are the two that I'm going to focus on. I'm going to focus on taking a listen to delay for pre-delay and also for delay in time as well for that. All right. And then for your justification, you're just writing down what you actually see on the page as your justification for it. Let's give this one a go and see how we get on.
Question 4. A. You will hear two versions of a piano track. The first version has no effects or processes. The second version has reverb applied. Listen to version 1 with no effects or processes. Listen to version 2. Identify the reverb settings used and justify your answer. You now have 30 seconds to complete your answer.
So, for this one, the correct answer would have been reverb setting number 1, and your justification for that, you're literally just saying exactly what it looks like on the page. The reverb time is very long, and then there's also a long pre-delay before any of the reverb is heard as well on that, and gives that kind of echo effect that you were hearing in the track there. Moving on to part B. Part B of this question always just has some kind of either musical or technological feature question. In this case, it's a musical feature because it's asking for the guitar playing technique. So if you're not too sure of your guitar playing techniques, then you might want to take a look on a website like ataa.co.uk or take a look at any of the revision materials your teacher has posted on Google Classroom so that you can see and revise the definitions of these.
B. Listen to another excerpt. Identify the guitar playing technique. The excerpt is short and will be played twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time. Here is the excerpt for the second time.
Okay, so for that question, the answer would have been harmonics, which are the kind of little bell tone sounds that you would have been hearing in the guitar excerpt there for that little short clip. Moving on to question number 5. Question number 5 is your IP or intellectual property issues question, where essentially it will give you some kind of court case that you get to take a look at. You get to read through and see what happened in the court, and then you're given 3 questions to answer based off of that. Now, if you would like to pause the video at this moment so that you can read through the question, then that's absolutely fine, and then we will continue when we move on to the next slide. So here are the questions that you are going to get asked within this kind of question. So part A, which feature of the music could be a breach of intellectual property? And remember, that's for excerpt 2. For B, describe how intellectual property protection benefited Ronnie Mac. So you're taking a look for the benefits of intellectual property there, and give one example of how George Harrison could have avoided a breach of intellectual property rights.
You will hear the excerpts twice with a pause of 15 seconds between playings. Here is excerpt 1 for the first time.
He's so fine. Wish you were mine.
Here is excerpt 2 for the first time.
My sweet Lord, my Lord, my Lord, I really want to see you.
Here is excerpt 1 for the second time.
He's so fine.
Here is excerpt 2 for the second time.
My sweet Lord, my Lord, my Lord, I really want to see you, really want to be with you, really want to see you, Lord, but it takes so long.
You now have 2 minutes to complete your answers for parts A, B and C.
So again, in the fab and in the exam, you would get these 2 minutes to basically finalise your answers for all three of these questions. But in the case of this video, we are just going to go over the answers and then move on swiftly. So the feature of the music in excerpt 2 that was a breach of intellectual property was the vocal melody. So you would get one mark for either saying the vocal melody or melody on its own. For B, describe how intellectual property protection benefited Ronnie Mac. The potential answers are there so that you could get the recognition he deserved or to get some form of compensation or financial compensation. And for part C, give one example of how George Harrison could have avoided a breach of intellectual property. He could have significantly changed the vocal melody, obtained permission to use melodic aspects of excerpt 1, or given a writing credit to Ronnie Mac for that. And those are an easy 3 marks that you can get in your IP question. The IP questions generally follow the same kind of formula each time, so just make sure to remember that order when you are revising, and that will help for your exam. Moving on to question 6, we are going to do part A first, then we're going to do part B and C together. Again, this is another one that's kind of multi-choice, so you can do process of elimination with this. You've got 2 terms from the list below to describe what you hear. We've got 3 different genres, then we have a technological feature in sample and a musical feature in whole tone scale. So one thing that you want to be kind of thinking of is it's going to be one of those genres, and then think what's more likely, the technological sample or the musical idea that's within that as well, and try to match them up before you hear it. So let's give this question a little go, and then we'll go over the answer to this one before we move on to part B and C of this question.
Question 6. This question features music from different genres, styles. A. Listen to this excerpt and identify 2 terms from the list below which describe what you hear. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the music for the first time. Here is the music for the second time.
So the two answers for this one would be R&B would be the genre that was there, and then sample would also go with it. You're very unlikely to get a whole tone scale with jazz, funk, world music or R&B, so straight away you should have been thinking of that answer there. So give yourself 2 marks if you're able to get that. Okay, we're moving on to 6B now. So this is going to give you an excerpt of an orchestral recording, and you have to describe in detail a suitable stereo miking technique you would use to achieve a similar recording. Now, for these kinds of questions, you don't always get something like an orchestra or a choir. You can just get random instruments here and there. Stereo miking is the hint that's in this question. So for your first mark, you need to be making sure that you're talking about the two types of microphone you're going to use, or the two microphones that you are going to use, in a sense. So what type of microphones are they, what's their polar pattern, and then what array are you going to place them in. And the second mark, you're going to be taking a look for where it should be placed, so thinking about where it would be placed in relation to the orchestra in this case. And then for your justification, you're wanting to think of environmental factors or kind of more technological factors that would, you know, benefit the recording as well. I would stick to environmental if you're not too sure. So think about the way the orchestra is laid out, why you would be recording it in the way that you are. And for part C, you're going to listen to the excerpt and write the concept that describes the texture of the backing vocals. If you're not too sure about your textures, I recommend you take a look on ataa.co.uk, but it's most likely to, at higher, be either homophonic or polyphonic. Those would be the two answers that I would be thinking of straight away. So let's give these questions a go, and then we'll go over the answers as we go along.
B. Listen to this excerpt of an orchestral recording. Describe in detail a suitable stereo miking technique you would use to achieve a similar recording. Justify your choice.
Thank you.
You now have two minutes to complete your answer.
So in the fab and also in the exam, you would have these 2 minutes. In the case of this video, if you would still like your 2 minutes, feel free to pause, and then I'm going to go over the answers in just a second. So for your first mark, you are wanting to think about, as I said, the type of microphone that you're going to use, the polar pattern, and then also the arrays as well. So for this, because it's a stereo, you're wanting to use a pair of cardioid condenser microphones in an XY position, or XY array in that case. For your actual placement, the microphones should be placed around about a metre or more above the orchestra. That's the only mark that you would get for that. And then the mark for your justification, you could talk about how this type of recording would give a good balance of direct sound and room ambience, so you're thinking about the environmental factors, or because it's a stereo recording, you can always go for the answer to ensure good stereo image as your justification. We'll now wait the rest of the 2 minutes before part C plays, and then go over the answer to that one.
Listen to this excerpt and write the concept which describes the texture of the backing vocals. The excerpt will be played twice. Here is the excerpt for the first time. Here is the excerpt for the second time.
Okay, so the answer that you're looking for this one was actually a little bit of a trick question when you hear it, because it says describe the texture of the backing vocals. Now we've got lead vocals and backing vocals in there. The backing vocals on their own had a homophonic texture, and it was because they were all moving at the same time. There wasn't any changes going in there. It was like big blocks. So give yourself 4 marks if you manage to get all of those correct on B and C. Moving on to question number 7. So we're going to start off with part A. So this question relates to 20th and 21st century styles and innovators of technological developments. So what you're to do is you are to choose a genre from the list and answer the question below, and give a detailed description of your chosen genre. So you need to talk about a key innovator, a key attribute, and a key technology. So you'll get 1 mark for the key innovator for naming it, 1 mark for a key attribute, so that's some kind of, you know, thing that's relevant to the genre, and then a key technology, so something that's a piece of technology that is used within the genre, and you are given 3 minutes to answer the question. There is no music played absolutely at all in this. What we'll do is we'll listen through and we'll kind of go from there, and I'll go over the possible answers that you can have from that.
Question 7.
This question relates to 20th and 21st century genres, styles, and innovators in technological developments. A. Choose a genre from the list and answer the question below. Tick one box to indicate your choice. You now have 3 minutes to answer the question. There will be no music played. A warning tone will sound 30 seconds before part B.
Okay, so after that warning tone sounds, you get another 30 seconds before part B, but we are just going to move on from here. So with this question, no matter what genre you tick from the list, you just need to justify a key innovator, a key attribute, and a key technology, and you will get your 3 marks. So for hip hop, you could have put as a key innovator, for example, somebody like Dr. Dre or Grandmaster Flash, Ice Cube, these kind of people. Key attribute, mixing using DJ decks, rapping, MCing and triggering samples, and then a key technology, DJ decks, drum machine, samplers, sequencers or synthesizers. For jazz funk, that's a little bit of a tricky one as well. For our key innovators, we could have the likes of Herbie Hancock or Snarky Puppy. Our key attribute could be electronic instrumentation with improvisation, irregular time signatures, syncopation, time changes, and key technology, modulation or filter effects on or wah-wah, Rhodes piano or a synthesizer. And our last one, reggae, I think everybody for their key innovator would probably go for Bob Marley for that one. Key attribute, beats 2 and 4, emphasized, repeated riff patterns, offbeat chords, expressive and soulful vocals, relaxed performance, backing vocals and harmony, prominent bass parts, syncopated bass lines. So similar to what you would put for your musical features. And then for your key technology, a Hammond organ, spring reverb, or some kind of delay as well on there. Okay, let's move on to question 7b. So in this case, you're now asked to choose a technology from the list below and answer the question. So No matter what technology you choose, as long as you are able to justify it using a key innovator and then one example of their influence on the development of the technology, then you would get your 2 marks in the form of this question. So the options we have are wax cylinder, synthesizer and microphone. Let's play through the question. Again, there's going to be no music playing throughout this. You'll get the 3 minutes to answer, then the warning tonal sound, and then I'll go over the answer at that point.
B. Choose a technology from the list and answer the question below. Tick one box to indicate your choice. You now have 3 minutes to answer the question. A warning tone will sound 30 seconds before the next question starts. So again, in that question, you would get another 30 seconds after the warning tone sounds before you move on to the next one. This question is quite a tricky one, so please, if you are really, really unsure, you need to take a look over your technological features and things like that. So like your wax cylinder, your synthesizers, your microphones, that kind of thing, and then get this extra information in. So let's go for the wax cylinder to start off with. The example of the key innovator that's in the marking scheme is Thomas Edison. And his example of the influence was that it was one of the first commercial mediums, and Edison perfected a solid wax cylinder which could be shaved down and used again. In the case of the synthesizer, the example of the key innovator that the marking scheme gives is Bob Moog, and Moog developed a voltage-controlled series of modules which could be patched together to create sound, so he essentially invented the synthesizer. And then for a microphone, the example of the key innovator was Dr. Harry F. Olson. And the example of the influence was that Olson was a key innovator of the ribbon microphone, which was a bi-directional microphone that was used extensively in the broadcasting industry. So if you manage to get any of those, give yourselves 2 marks. So remember, 1 mark for the key innovator and 1 mark for the example of the influence for that. Okay, and now we're taking a look at question number 8. So
What's going to happen is you're going to see in just a second a guide to the audio that's going to play in the clip, and further information is required and must be inserted in the spaces. So it's essentially a fill the blanks question. You get a pause of 40 seconds to allow you to read through the question. The music's then played three times, and then there's a pause of 15 seconds between the playings, and a voice helps guide through the numbered sections on the page. So let's take a look at the little table that we've got. So for number one, a something EQ is used to find and remove harsh frequency in the guitar track. Now, usually you would think cutting and boosting of high, mid, low. In this case, it's not asking for that. It's asking for the type of EQ. So you're wanting to think things like graphic, parametric, that kind of thing for that. So what kind of EQ? On Reaper, we tend to use the parametric EQ to do that kind of thing. So I would be thinking that straight away. For number two, the synth strings plays a or an, and then a blank. The control and effect on the synth lead track are what and what. The something control is adjusted on the synth. The drum kit something is soloed to allow the reverb to be adjusted. And number six, the Italian term to describe the change in tempo is something. So we need to be thinking our effects, we need to be thinking our musical concepts, and we need to be thinking about our technological concepts as well in this case. So let's give this question a go and we will mark it at the end.
Question 8. Listen to this excerpt of an engineer mixing an audio recording. A guide to the audio is laid out below. You will see that further information is required and must be inserted in the spaces. There will now be a pause of 40 seconds to allow you to read through the question.
The music will be played three times with a pause of 15 seconds between playings. In each playing, a voice will help guide you through the numbered sections. Here is the music for the first time. 1. Two. Three. Four. Here is the music for the second time. One. Two. Three. Thank you. 4. Here is the music for the third time. One. Two. Three. Four.
Okay, let's go over the answers to that question. So for number one, it was a parametric EQ that was used to find and remove a harsh frequency in the guitar track. For number two, the synth string played an inverted pedal, so that was that nice high sustained note that you would have heard at the top. For number three, the control and effect on the synth lead track are, the first one was portamento, which was the sliding that you could hear between the notes, and then also a phaser, but also accepted would be a flanger or a glide as well for that. So you would get a mark for either of those ones. For number four, it was the release control that was adjusted on the synth. You could hear it there because it was kind of quiet. It felt like it wasn't quite coming off at certain points. For number five, the drum kit submix is soloed to allow the reverb to be adjusted. Now, all of you have already done a drum kit submix in your practice multi-tracks earlier on in the year, but also accepted are group or bus as options to fill that in there for that mark. And the Italian term used to describe the change in tempo is either rallentando or ritardando, because it was getting gradually slower. Let's move on to the last question now. So this is question number nine. So what happens is you get a minute to read through the question. So you see all these options that are up here. So for example, clarinet plays a solo, flanger effect on electric guitar, time changes, irregular time signatures, harmonizer on vocals, oboe plays a solo, tremolo effect on electric guitar, portamento on synth strings, tambourine panned right, and arpeggios are broken chords on the electric guitar. Now, this is why I wanted you to wear headphones in this video, because you will need it for the panning just to check as well, all right? So, you have to pick five of these that are listed, 5 out of 10. If you are not sure with this question about any, you're actually better off having a guess, because you've got a 50% chance of getting a mark realistically for these. So, the music's played three times and then you get 2 minutes at the end to complete your answer. Let's play through the question, and then for the 2 minute silence, we will go over the answers for this before it finishes.
Question nine. Listen to this excerpt of music. You must identify five music production features present in the music from the 10 listed below. You will hear the music three times with a pause of 15 seconds between each playing. You now have one minute to read through the question.
Here is the music, for the first time. Here is the music for the second time. Here is the music for the third time.
You now have two minutes to complete your answer.
Okay, so the answers to this question were arpeggios are broken chords on electric guitar, the oboe was playing a solo, the tambourine was panned to the right, there were time changes present, and there was a tremolo effect on the electric guitar, and there's no other answers accepted for that. So mark that out of five to give yourself a mark for that, and then total up the amount that you got. That's the walkthrough of the past paper. That is the end of this paper. Thank you very much for watching, and hopefully this will be of good use to you for your FABs and for your exam revision. Hope everything goes well.